2010-2011 Penn men's basketball season kind of fast approaching and creeping up. The Quakers have actually been going through preliminary preseason workouts over the last few weeks. The official start date for preseason practices on October 15th. In place, the leadership trio for the red and blue for the upcoming season. It'll be Conor Turley, a senior big, Zack Rosen back for his junior season at the point, and fellow forward along with Conor, Jack Eggleston. So guys, first of all, this is a great privilege, a great honor for you guys to be captaining the Quakers in 2010-2011. And Conor, I'll start with you. I mean, you have endured your fair share of adversity here during your time at Penn. To receive this recognition from the rest of the team, it's got to be pretty sweet, pretty special.
Yeah, I mean, I'd say it feels pretty good that the coaches have that confidence in me, but at the same time, when people congratulate me, I think I feel more of a sense of responsibility than anything else to perform this year and help lead these guys along with Jack and Zack to our main goal, which is an Ivy title.
Zack, for the rest of the Quakers, to see the work ethic of someone like Conor fighting through injuries, having to spend time on the sidelines, what message does that send to the rest of you guys?
I think it sends a message that that's where Coach Allen wants our leadership to be, and that's the kind of effort that he's going to demand from all of us. So Conor being named captain is an honor for him. It's an honor. It's an example for the rest of us, and I think it's kind of just matching his toughness every day and his dirty play from time to time, and Jack will attest to that. But I'm happy for him, I'm happy for us, and I think together the three of us will make it happen.
It's constructive dirty play though, right, Jack?
Oh, of course, and I have my fair share as well.
You're coming off a great 2009-2010 season among the Ivy League's top 10 in scoring, second in rebounding. Where do you think your game grew the most last year now, heading into your final year at Penn?
I don't think it was much a factor of my game personally as it was of just the situation. You know, we had Mike Hallett out for half the year. Conor missed the latter half of the Ivy League season. Andreas missed the whole season. So it just was more a factor of the circumstance, myself being asked to step up. You know, I didn't do anything outrageous, kind of was my normal self, just get out there, do the hard work, make the little plays, and I just got the opportunities. So hopefully we can build on that, and with all these guys back, we'll be a well-rounded and balanced team.
You and Conor were just talking about the aggressive post play that Penn has been experiencing during the early preseason workouts so far. If you could have an ideal identity, personality, that this program assumes for 2010-2011, what would you want that to be?
I'd want it to be that we're an incredibly tough team, that they look at the schedule and say, oh, Penn, I don't want to play these guys. You know, I want people to not enjoy the prospect of playing us, and I want them to, the next morning when they roll out of bed, remember that they played us.
So, Zack, with that being said, does that kind of place a premium on the early portion of the season, the non-conference games, for you guys to find that identity and show what you guys are?
I think we've already started to find that identity. Starting in September, starting last summer, when we all got together and stuck around campus. And I think it'll be more than just a couple games in the first part of that season that's been able to forge this identity that we're trying to create. And I think we're almost there. I think guys are putting in the effort, buying in, and it's about everybody. It's not about us three. It's about, you know, however many guys, 15, together buying in and creating that effort.
So this is your third year on the squad. I mean, this captain stuff, this is all old hat by now, right? This is your second year as a captain on the team. And last year, obviously, was difficult for a lot of different reasons for Penn. Did you feel that going through that sharpened, enhanced your leadership skills at all in any particular ways?
First of all, I think captain is just a title. I think that whether I was captain or not, I'd be the same person that these guys don't like from time to time, and but going through that is, you know, as Coach Allen always talks about, is let it be part of your testimony, let it be, commit to the process, and have something to talk about when it's all said and done. And I think the first 2 years, the first 3 years for these guys, is going to be part of our testimony that we went through that, we've been there, we know what it's like, and we don't want to experience again. So it's going to drive us, and we'll be talking about that with smiles at some point.
Conor, as the official start of the preseason approaches for the Red and Blue, what's encouraged you the most about what you've seen from the team so far during these preliminary workouts that you guys have had?
I guess I'd say that everyone's working hard. We had our mile test. We've been out on the track. We're up every morning working hard, and it just seems like everyone's buying in. Everyone's trying to do their part. And collectively as a group, I've been happy with the guys. So hopefully we can continue to do that.
The Quakers' schedule was announced a few weeks back, and there are some definitely notable names on that. It begins with Davidson here at the Palestra on November the 13th, a post-Thanksgiving trip to Pitt, at Kentucky on January 3rd. Of course, the Big Five games, the Ivy League schedule. What excites you the most about the slate for the Quakers this year?
Honestly, we're trying to win the Ivy title this year. That's the main goal. And I feel like we need to approach every game the same way. We need to play with a certain sense of toughness. We need to bring it every day. And I think if we do that, we'll look back on this season, and I think we'll be happy with what we've accomplished.
And it will definitely be a real fascinating dynamic for this group. Some veterans on the team and some newcomers coming in as well to create the identity for the Quakers in 2010-2011. All right, guys, we will wrap it up. We'll do this. We'll go Conor first, Jack, allow for the microphone exchange back to Zack. The thing that you think will surprise Penn observers or impress them the most in 2010-2011? We'll go with you, Conor.
I guess off the top of my head that we won't have a whole row of injured guys behind the bench. I think that'll be refreshing for the fans to see. But, yeah, I think our fans should be very excited for this year because we are.
Jack?
I'd have to say how well 24-year-old Conor Turley's still moving. I mean, for as old as he is, he still gets up and down the floor pretty well.
Zack?
Brian Seltzer.
No. Aside from that.
A lot of new faces, a lot of little rookies, and a lot of old veterans. Do they have an average in college basketball? Like age for...
Right behind BYU.
We could probably get
we
on that.
We got to be up there.
we'll put Stats Incorporated on that.
Age. That's what it is.
So good health for the Quakers going into the meat of the preseason. That officially gets underway on October 15th. The Quakers captained this year by senior forward Conor Turley, senior forward Jack Eggleston, junior point guard Zack Rosen. Continuing coverage of the Penn Quakers men's basketball program all throughout the preseason right here on PennAthletics.com.